In the real world, you are exposed to multiple stressors of varying magnitude. They push and pull you in different directions. It might be helpful to think of these in terms of vectors, like in physics. Everyone experiences multiple vectors that are additive and generate a net effect. These stressors exist on four levels. First, the physical environment. Second, the individual level. Third, the group. And fourth, the organizational. For the purposes of this course, we're going to focus on the first three. Typical stressors in the physical environment are what you might imagine: noise level, lighting, and temperature of the room. Depending on your environment, it may also include things like vibration, movement, or air quality. Relative extremes of temperature are common in your line of work. Think about the last time you sat in a frigid operating room or melted while rounding on the burn unit. Turning up the room temperature is good for resuscitating your bleeding trauma patient, but it is simultaneously a stressor for those providing care. Stressors at the individual and group level are far less concrete. At the individual level, stressors are related to the role you play and the tasks you must accomplish. This includes ambiguity about your position within an organization and conflict with others, as well as things like time pressure, workload, and the threat of physical harm. In the case of healthcare providers, I would even argue that we internalize some degree of personal responsibility for our patients and may therefore experience threats to them as personal threats to our own well-being. Generally, though, changes in performance are related to two types of individual stressors: the demands of the task, the depletion of available resources, or both. This makes sense with what we already know about the brain's cognitive appraisal of a situation and our definition of stress. Increasing task demands or running out of physical and mental resources shifts your brain's assessment of a situation to threat, which results in stress. As situations intensify, the size of your team may grow, creating group stressors. Crowding is one example which strains your cognitive resources, affects your ability to carry out physical tasks, and leads to increased errors. As the group continues to grow, other stressors may emerge, such as lack of cohesiveness, intra-group conflict, and group dissatisfaction. At this group level, you perceive stressors due to the influence of the group on you as an individual. And as the team leader, you feel responsibility for the performance of other individuals in the group, as well as the group as a whole. These specific types of stressors can draw attention away from task-related activities as stress builds. But to truly appreciate and understand some stressors, we need to talk about the specific sensations involved and how they feel.